Today we will discuss tetralogy of Fallot's. It is the most common congenital cyanotic heart disease and it has most favorable outcome. Four essential components are pulmonary stenosis, ventricular septal defect, right ventricular hypertrophy and overriding of aorta. We will first discuss pulmonary stenosis. Due to pulmonary stenosis, right ventricle is strained and there is right ventricular hypertrophy. This pulmonary stenosis will produce an ejection systolic murmur, and intensity of this ejection systolic murmur will be inversely related to severity of the pulmonary stenosis. More stenosis, intensity will be less, and due to this pulmonary stenosis there is cyanosis, and this cyanosis is directly proportional to the severity of stenosis. More stenosis, more cyanosis. Right ventricular flow obstruction results in delayed P2, and P2 is reduced in intensity because of reduced pulmonary pressure. Only A2, aortic component of second heart sound, is audible. Due to pulmonary stenosis, right-sided blood is centered to left side, and so there is arterial unsaturation, polycythemia, cyanosis, poor pulmonary vascularity, clubbing, anoxic, hypoxic or blue spells, S due to cerebral anoxia, VSD. There is large enough VSD in this condition, and so pressure is equal in both the ventricles, and so there is no murmur. And this pressure, increase in pressure in right ventricle may contribute to right ventricular hypertrophy. And due to this right ventricular hypertrophy, there are ECG changes, right axis deviation, and right ventricular hypertrophy lag changes in ECG. X-ray will show oligemic lung fields and boot-shaped heart due to right ventricular hypertrophy. Sometimes right aortic arch may be seen. Complications are infective endocarditis, hemiplegia and brain abscess due to thrombosis and embolism. Heart failure is rare. Treatment is general treatment and specific treatment. General treatment is correction of iron deficiency anemia, dehydration and antibiotic for infection. Management of hypercyanotic spell with promethazine and propranolol tablets. And surgical treatment is main treatment. Surgical treatment, definitive surgical treatment and palliative surgical treatment. Definitive surgical treatment is repair of this VSD and this pulmonary stenosis with artificial patch. And palliative treatment is, as there is poor flow of blood in pulmonary circulation. We want to improve pulmonary circulation. More blood will go to lungs and more oxygenated blood will be available for systemic use. So usually we divert blood from arteries. We make connection with subclavian artery and pulmonary artery. We need to dilate this stenotic portion of pulmonary artery. We may place a stent in this stenotic portion of pulmonary artery. We can create side to side anastomosis between this pulmonary artery and aorta. This is all about tetralogy of Fallot. Thank you very much.